Welcome to my new video about batch programming. This video will be about my newest project, the Batch Explorer, which isn't finished yet, so it will just be a preview. It is an alternative to the common Windows Explorer, and it just shows the folders and the files and so on, as you see. You can see all commands by typing help, which will open the help menu on the top, and then go to comments. Pause the video to read all comments if you want to, but you may notice that the help comment exists twice, the batch explorer one and the batch comment. To use the batch comment though, you may use call help instead of just help, because help will open the menu. So, by typing next, you go to the next page, which is in this case the first file page. By typing previous, you go to the previous page. Now let's see the properties of Windows. In comparison to the original one, the folder name is the same, the type as well, the location, and the file size, which is a pretty cool effect in the Batch Explorer, in my opinion, will hopefully be the same as well. And the creation date and the other dates are also the same. No attributes here, which is also correct, and done. Now, you may have noticed the sidebar, which is a display to show you where you are. The file system is the Batch Explorer itself, the folders and the files. Desktop is the desktop, as it says. Trash is the recycle bin. And Ducky, in my case, is my username, which is the user's profile directory. Now let's go to trash. As you may notice, it has a type, a file and folder's name, and the true name. And you may notice that the dots have moved. The errors a few seconds ago are in case you have used your drives for CDs and DVDs on that day yet. Anyway, by typing view, you get to the view menu, which is just a summary of all files and folders, and in the trash it has also the original paths. Now, we are making a new folder in the F drive called YouTube Batch Explorer, and we are going into it by typing file explorer, and now we are making a new file called test.log. Now let's edit this file in the command notepad, change something, save it, close it, and type it in the Batch Explorer after renewing. Now let's cut the file out, and you will see that it disappears. And now let's paste it back again. By pasting it twice, it will ask you to overwrite the file. And here we go. Now, the desktop function hasn't finished yet, but I have an imagination of what it will look like So I just call desktop.bat, which I have prepared before the video. And each file and folder has its particular icon. And the menus on the top still exist. I hope it looks a bit familiar to the common desktop. In my opinion it does, but yeah. If you need help, just type help and then help center, and you get to the frequently asked questions, support and a few covered errors. Pause the video to read it. Yeah, and that's it. I hope you like it and have fun batching.